the pension fund to get out of fossil fuels. It is becoming increasingly clear that it is the financial duty, the financially wise thing to get out of fossil fuels. It is going to be a negligence of fiduciary duty to continue to invest in fossil fuels. After we're finished here, the speakers will be invited to go up to Mayor Murray's office to deliver an endorsement letter that has been signed by all the speakers and a large number of other folks from around the Seattle community, including the Sierra Club, President of the Washington Positions for Social Responsibility, about 20 faith leaders and 20 academics. And we will be delivering a financial report that we commissioned from the former director of the North American Derivative Trading Association at UDS that shows that by continuing to invest in fossil fuels in the last 10 years, the city of Seattle has lost $65 million. Had it excluded fossil fuels from its portfolio 3 years ago, it would have made $53 million more. Not only are we continuing to give moral license and to fund the fossil fuel industries whose basic economic models are completely incompatible with preventing major climate destabilization, but we are wasting Seattle's taxpayer dollars to do so. This isn't just me saying this, this is becoming increasingly recognized. One of the world's most reputable financial analysis firms, Kepler Cheuvreux, has estimated that the carbon bubble, the amount of total fossil fuel reserves that could be wiped from the market if we take the actions necessary to prevent catastrophic climate change, are valued to be $22 trillion. And I want to share a quote from a fellow employee of Vivian's. This is a quote from Dr. Bruce Flory, who is the principal economist at Seattle Public Utilities. Divesting is not only the right thing to do, it is the prudent thing to do. The stock value of fossil fuel companies reflects expectations of their future profits, which are based on their known reserves and the assumption those reserves will be fully exploited. But the survival of human society depends most on those reserves being left in the ground. Yeah. Becomes clear to the market, the value of fossil fuel stocks will crash. Smart investors will have already divested. This is coming from a principal economist at the City of Seattle. We are asking City of Seattle to do the morally right thing and to be a smart investor with taxpayer dollars and with the pension fund of their employees. Unanimously passed City Council resolution introduced by Mick McCara, and picking up that baton and reigniting this fight, we have Council Member Solanix, who is going to talk about how City Council supported full fossil fuel divestment then and supports it even more now.
Thank you. to staff on the board to immediately take action and divest now.
Thank you.
retirement fund being spent on fossil fuel companies and funding the fossil fuel industry. We do have people who are going around us now with petitions. So if you are a city employee, if you are a city retiree and you have not yet joined the hundreds who have signed our petition, please find the petition folks who are currently waving their arms around and do so. But one point is that it isn't only city employees' money that is being wasted in the fossil fuel industry. Two-thirds of the City of Seattle pension fund is provided by Seattle's taxpayer dollars. So it is all of us who are currently having our taxpayer dollars spent investing in companies like Energy Transfer, Exxon, Shell, Chevron, companies who again and again and again have not only shown that they have no interest in taking action on climate change, but have abused marginalised communities around the planet. That is not okay to spend your money in those companies. Deliver a report to Councilmember Burgess's office because he's the chair of the board of the pension fund. Then we're going to go up to the seventh floor to deliver the report along with an endorsement letter signed by many members of the Seattle community, urging Mayor Murray to immediately express public support, respond to this outpouring of public outcry by expressing his public support for fossil fuel divestment and instructing his appointees on the board to vote in favour of the investments. So we're going to do a little chant, and then we're going to walk up there and just deliver our reports to the office. The speakers have been invited to come in. If everyone else just wants to wait outside, if you want to repeat the chant as we're inside, loud enough so maybe city council members can hear it. We have no control for that. So the chant is very simple. It's just no coal, no oil.
Thank you. like there isn't a process.
Yeah, right? There isn't. So you can get involved any quicker you want.
Now,
So, yeah, I have plans on going out. It's actually like the following week that we made that decision. So I ended up by canceling my plans, like assuming that that holds until, you know, the president's like, you know.
Well, now look where we're at. Now they're terminated.
Right. That's what I kind of figured.
Now we're fighting, so.
You know, but now the scope is changed. You know, I mean, I would still like to go out there, but there's a lot of other things.
Well,
I
think the dynamics have changed. Yeah, the dynamics have really changed in regards
it's to not just being, you know, local.
People going out there and things, because now they're trying to clean up. If you are going out there, do you have someone to stay with? You know, those kinds of, you know, those kinds of things. So, because it's not just, it's not just bringing the attention anymore. Now there's, you got to evacuate, floodlands, there's a lot of dynamics involved now. So, but doing all of this stuff and communicating with the cities and our communities and our friends and everybody divesting, that's what the next, you know, step is. Oh.
Even though we're having a conversation. But
do you know what I mean, though? So the next steps are really people just still getting informed about, you know, the effect that these fossil fuels have on our economy, on our communities, on our environments. So now, you know, people aren't expanding rock as in regards to what I mean by not expanding rock. People aren't getting caravans and traveling over there. So now we're finding ways in our cities, in our local communities to get involved. And so, like I was telling you, you know, that's where we need to start talking to our friends about divesting. Find out where our cities are ranking and moving this movement to get them to divest from fossil fuels. And so, and now it's, you know, we're starting with the universities and all, you know, churches and all of these things, because it's crazy how much money is really involved in all of our day-to-day stuff.
Hey man, how you doing?
So we're gonna keep fighting, we're gonna keep, you know, resisting, we're gonna keep getting cities to divest, we're gonna keep getting people to divest, and it's not just for part of the 17 banks that run the U.S. There's Bank of America, there's Citibank, there's a number of banks that are involved. So, you know, I know a lot of people have been looking for just Wells Fargo, but you know, from the U.S. So that's definitely what we're trying to do. Businesses, you know, we need to come to solutions. We need to come to with reasons of why society says we don't invest in fossil fuels. Why should we not invest in fossil fuels? What are the issues it's causing? What is it doing to your city specifically? So one thing we've done is take local issues and tie them in with our divestment. So, you know, we've referenced the Puget Sound, you know, the coal trains coming in, the oil terminal on the west coast, the river encroachment on the Duwamish River, and we bring all of those issues in with this one, and we make it relevant so that people can, they can relate with it. And I think if you have a fight that people can relate with, then you can get that movement going and get other people involved. And that's what we want to do is, you know, we've got a victory with this. Now it is that, you know, we want to work with people. We want people to divest in cities. We want grassroots movements to get involved and to basically stir things up. Because after the administrations come in and they're doing things left and right, and their orders coming in left and right, you know, as people, we have to find ways that we can have some power. And we can give power in pressure, with power in numbers, we can give power in making sure that people remove their money from the fossil fuel.
So I'm